A woman's path to a secure retirement is filled with obstacles, such as lower pay and time spent out of the workforce parenting, which could be more true today than ever as a lot of children are home from school because of coronavirus. Local financial professional Jeff Bangerter from Bangerter Financial Services is joining us with a guide for women to take control of our finances and also our future. Good morning, Jeff. Good to see
you. Good morning, May. How are you?
Good, thanks. All right, so let's start with this. The need to save money now more than ever. Let's talk about the unique circumstances that women may find themselves in.
Yeah, it is. You know, I think women do have kind of a unique situation. First off, they live longer than men, right? So typically 6 to 8 years longer. Mm-hmm. Women also retire earlier, about a year and a half earlier than men. And honestly, the parenting duties fall mostly to women, so it does impact your earning abilities over your lifetime. And The other thing is health care. Your health care costs are actually more over your lifetime, too. So all of those are concerns.
And there are even more concerns today. Trying to create a budget so that women can plan for retirement, but as well as right now, that they may have to stay home more because of their children being home from school because of coronavirus concerns, and also having to maybe pay for childcare or childcare that is not there. That's a big stressor. How do you weigh in these unexpected circumstances into a budget for a woman?
Well, I think that really when you think about it, first off, about 6 in 10 women have set up budgets, so that's good, but you know, the other 40%, right, have not. And so I think you do have to have these emergency valves kind of in place. So when you're doing your budgeting, you want to look at your income. You want to also look at the expenses you're normally going to have. Mm-hmm. But as we've talked in past interviews, we think that you should absolutely have at least 6 months of your income readily available in a savings account. And I know that's tough to say right now that, you know, if you haven't done it, then you're kind of behind the eight ball. But if you have, you have that peace of mind. So I think that, you know, as we get through this, which we will, then you need to make sure that you take the time to set up that budget. And I have a worksheet on my website at bangerterfinancial.com to help folks get started. But this time, absolutely do it and make sure you have that emergency savings account set up.
All right, good advice. Jeff, also, another tip you have there is pay yourself first. And this is different, say, for 2020.
It really is. So the key to this, right, is I think most people sometimes think that the amount they put in, if it's not enough, it doesn't matter. But honestly, whether it's large or small amounts, they compound over time. And so for retirement planning, you want to look out, you know, hopefully far enough in advance that you can really have a good strategy for it start putting money aside. And for those of us that are over 50, we can actually do the catch-up contributions, which is $26,000 for the year 2020.
Wow.
So there is opportunity to put a lot of money into a 401k plan. And if you don't have one at work, then certainly set up an IRA.
Mm-hmm. Good information, good education, and that, of course, is always your last tip, to get educated about this. And for more information, we'll just go on your website, bangerterfinancial.com. Thank you, Jeff Bangerter, for being with us this morning. Stay safe and healthy out there. Absolutely.